Okay, so the theorem was that there is a generic set of Lipschitz functions such that the maximizing measure is supported on a periodic orbit. We saw previously first that generically the maximizing measure has zero entropy, and second, that there were certain good pseudo orbits that were like this. We will ask them to have at most two jumps. It was a finite time, but a finite number of jumps, but we will use it two. And then they are, say, delta pseudo orbits and the minimal approximation is of the pseudo orbit was gamma, and so we will have what we need is a sequence of pseudo orbits which have say gamma over delta tending infinity. So this is the situation we need. And we will see today how to obtain this kind of pseudo orbits from zero entropy. Okay. And, so. Okay. The argument is by contradiction. So we have to see what happens if we are not in this situation. So if we are not in that situation, that means that, for example, a generic point for the maximizing measure will have returns, but each time we have a very small return, the approximation, the middle approximation, is not large with respect to delta, no? So bad situation or we don't get the returns. de good pseudo orbits. If each time that we have a return which is small, gamma, the minimal approximation, is not large with respect to delta. So it's, there is a bound for the minimal approximation with respect to delta. And so gamma is less than Q times delta. So what can we do? So the idea will be if if we have this small approximation, what we can do is cut the return and say, for example, we can cut here and make a new pseudo orbit and hope that this new pseudo orbit is a good one with the other inequality here. But in that case, we actually have two returns of this size. The other one is this one. So the green one is a pseudo orbit with two jumps of this size. So you will have, if both of them are not good, then we will have a return as well again, and each of them will we can cut them and split them and probably we will get four returns. And so the idea will be to obtain exponential growth of the quantity of returns. And that will contradict the entropy zero. Yes? Okay. So how we do this first, use this trick of making the function less than or equal to zero, and then we take generically the maximizing measure is unique, so it is ergodic. So we take a generic point for the measure. Okay, that's enough. A generic point for the measure. And so what I was saying is we are arguing by contradiction, so there will be a fixed proportion Q such that in the support of mu, each time we have a pseudo orbit of at most two jumps with a jumps of size delta, then there must be an approximation of this size. Okay. and then, well, we use so take a point where Brinkatok theorem holds. So the entropy is the exponential decay of the measure of a dynamic ball. This is the definition of the dynamic ball. And okay, the argument we will see is actually an argument on the dimension of the measure, and this is the way of relating a dynamic ball with a usual ball in a hyperbolic dynamics. So the measure of a dynamic ball can be estimated by the amount of time that an orbit spends in the dynamic ball. And we will get a contradiction by proving that the measure of a dynamic ball decreases exponentially. That will imply that the entropy is positive and then contradicts the theorem of Morris. Okay, and the way we're going to estimate the measure of a ball is by estimating how much time an orbit in the support of the measure spends outside of a ball, so that the measure of the ball decreases. So we are not going to use dynamic balls. We are going to use usual balls, and there is this relationship between normal balls and dynamic balls. So what we need is that the measure of the ball decreases exponentially with the radius of the ball. So, so take the sequence of all times in which a fixed generic point Q visits the ball. And we are going to prove that each time it visits the ball, the next time takes at least an amount of time which depends exponentially on the on n, which is the the size, the radius of the ball. So the radius of the ball decreases exponentially here, and then the amount of time that it takes before it comes back increases exponentially. And then when we can calculate the amount of time that is spent in the ball decreases exponentially. So this is the proposition that we need to show. Okay, and the way it is done is like I was saying in this blackboard. We start with a return. So we have this ball was, I think, W. of Q to minus n. And a return to the ball. And this pseudo orbit, I will draw it as a circle. Which is the first picture, but the since I have a return here of size q to the minus n, there must be an approach gamma. So this is delta, and gamma is less than Q times delta. So it's a, if I start with a pseudo orbit of size Q to the minus n, I get an approach of the next size Q to the minus n plus one, which is this, this number, the size of the approach. There will be say these points, which are giving the approach. I will draw them as a line here. And then to the right hand side, I see a pseudo orbit with two jumps here. One jump here of size q to the minus n, another jump of size q to the minus n plus one. So this is a candidate for my cutting process, and then there must be an approach of this next size q to the minus n plus two, this size, and this other one is a pseudo orbit of with only one jump of size q to the minus n plus one. And this one then should be an approach. And we iterate the process. Here there is a pseudo orbit with two jumps, and then it implies this one. In this case, here we have a pseudo orbit with two jumps. And the approach is, one of the points of the approach is exactly, happens to be here exactly at the previous approach. So that the line is not interior. So we have to count how many points in the in the original approach. The original approach was, or the original pseudo orbit is two times in which the generic point passes through the ball. So this is like a TNI, and this is like TMI plus one. So if we make sure that each at each new approach there is a new point in the pseudo orbit, the distance here will be something like larger than the number of approaches. And we can take the delta small enough such that since there are no periodic orbits, each time we have a pseudo orbit of at most two jumps, of jump size delta, the the length of a pseudo orbit has to be at least 100, say. And then that means that that each time we get a new approach, we make sure that there is a quantity of points in the approach of at least 100. And in order to make the accounting of this, we will use a tree. Here the tree reflects this picture. So we start with one return, and then we have an approach. This approach of size n minus one has at the right, we see one jump. So this is one jump. And at the left, we see zero jumps. And then there will be an approach to the right, which sees one jump, and one jump here. And to the left, another, which sees one jump to the right and one jump to the left. And we have to make sure that this tree grows exponentially. And we get the third. So we can count. Well, there is a problem sometimes in which one of the approaches is exactly at the end point of the previous approaches. So if we are counting the end points of the approaches, we may, may fail being duplicating all the time. So, and the other way to count is that, just to observe that if we have one very small approach, then in the middle, there must be at least, say, 100 points. So in that case, we just will count the branches of the tree, which are given by the, which are the new approaches. And then, so one of the problems, there are going to be three kinds of problems. One problem is when we have a return and the new approach is exactly one of the previous approaches. In that case, what we do is, make the accounting a bit different. I will put in, instead of Q here, one half of Q. So the new approaches are given by one half of Q, and then we make this observation. This new one here is one half of Q, and this was one half Q to minus b plus 1, and the previous one was q to the minus b, so the distance, so this one is of the next level, and then this one will also be of the next level. So that both sides, this one is an approach and this one is an approach as well, okay? And there may be another problem, which is when both endpoints of the approaches are, the new approach is at the both endpoints of the approaches. In that case, we don't have new endpoints to count, so I would put in the tree a white node, which does not count, but that case is like this, that the two sides of the node will have a zero, will be pseudo orbits with only one jump. And that starts the duplication process again. The other problem, so these are the three kinds of problems, no? A triangle, a quadrilateral, and where is it? This green. At the right side, this look sees a pseudo orbit which has three jumps, and then we stop the process when I am asking just for two jumps, because otherwise it gets too complicated. And so in that case, the tree is not duplicating. Okay. So that is the explanation of a quadrilateral when we have the approach given by the endpoints, and we see that this is an approach, and then from this point to this is also an approach, and from this to this is also an approach. So we have we make the shadow, and the other sides are pseudo orbits. And then we have to see how the tree behaves. We will, no? If we have a node in the tree with a zero, then it may be followed by this picture or this picture. And if and these are all the the what follows in the tree is from a node which has a one. And then we concatenate these things and see all the possibilities. And these are all the possibilities when it is dashed. It seems is that there can be more things here. And we see that in all the possibilities at in two levels, so we start with the upper part. In the next two levels, there are at least two new black points. So we have at least two new points in the process, in the tree, in the next two levels, and also at least two end branches. That means that in at two steps, the tree is duplicating. So it grows at an exponential rate of square root of two. And that's it. this kind of argument say was inspired by an argument by Magne in the proof of the stability conjecture. Magne makes two papers, and one of the papers is to obtain a heteroclinic connections, and the hypothesis was that he would have take a saddle point, and then he would look at the at a measure given by one by one branch, no, by an orbit, no, a limit measure of an orbit in one branch of the stable or unstable manifold, and he would put the hypothesis that that measure has a limit which gives a positive measure to the point. And he will be in the situation that if you have a return here of size delta such that the next approaches to the same point that was are large, then you can perturb to make the homoclinic connection. And then, by contradiction, he would suppose that this situation does not hold for very small deltas. And then he would see that the approaches the approaches are increased exponentially with the size of delta, and then the measure cannot give much measure to the saddle point. No, must leave a lot of measure behind, and that was a contradiction in Magnier's. In this case, the difference in this case is that the approaches are not to the same point. And then the approaches are in the middle, you don't know where, and this was the solution. My first approach was like looking at the dimension of the diagonal of the dynamical signal. No, this is like a epsilon distance to a diagonal in which of x by x. Okay, thank you very much.